You were hanging from the cliff filming us.
I know.
I can't wait to see that.
I've run up ahead so many different times just to get some good footage.
We can't even keep track of where you are.
I was doing about 110 at one point with all the gear on there. Made the bike a little bit wobbly. Plus, I don't have the proper air pressure because I'm planning.
That's the gravel there today, huh?
For off road, you know. So a couple of hairy times there. But it's been a brilliant day. Beautiful out here. I can't believe how beautiful it is. Have a nice day. Have a nice day. Have a nice day. Have a nice day. Ride around all day. Have a nice day. So once again, we've taken a wrong turn and now we're looking for directions. So have a nice day. Have a nice day. Have a nice day. Have a nice day.
Less than 3.5 miles.
Could possibly be any more hazards on this road?
Well, I could put some spikes coming out of the road.
Spikes?
Yeah.
Spikes would help, yeah.
And maybe some wires about that high.
Mines, you know, yeah.
This is insane.
Douglas.
Yeah, we did this like we went.
You taking off?
Yeah, we, so we.
How about the roads today?
The roads.
How about this last road?
The first dirt part was awesome. It was very gravelly, and I handled it pretty well, I thought, for Brian.
Yeah.
Then off that, wind.
Oh yeah.
It was windy as shit.
Wind
and then
was.
Coming this last 60K was hell.
Yeah.
Fucking hell. Saw a bear. I pulled up.
Yeah.
I was pulling down, I was all by myself, so I was pulling down, like, right out of town here, and I saw this spot on the right-hand side of the road, and I went, that looks like a dog or a wolf, and then I got close, I was about 30 yards, like, from here to that Pioneer Paul's sign, and I went, it's a fucking bear, and I stopped the bike, and he looked at me, and I went, I can't really turn around, because I don't want to, I do not want to put my back to this thing, and I got no place else to go anyways but forward. So I sat there, he looked at me, looked at him, I beeped the horn, he went like, yeah, what you got for me, son? Because he was about my size, and not that I would take him, because he's a bear, you know?
Right.
And so then I revved the engine, and he looked at me, and he bolted up the hill. And I was afraid there's going to be more coming behind him, like cubs or something.
There was 5 of them.
Was there really?
Yeah.
No way.
Yeah.
You saw bears?
Yeah, there were 5 of them.
Well, I saw one of them. Shit. And so I bolted on.
You almost got stuck in a bear, the classic bear ambush. The one hanging out at the road while the other 4 sneaking up behind you.
That's true. But I went around them. It's a badass.
Beautiful car, huh?
It brought us right there. And here we landed. And there's, you know. You know.
Like a rock star walking in.
Never in
this. Try some of this there, sweetheart. It's tropical. Tropical douche.
Here's walking to the mist.
It's coming. Taste for it. I'm glad I was freaking here.
No, we weren't there. It's over there. The bridge is over there. And it wasn't
cold.
I didn't. I don't smoke cigars.
Who smokes cigars?
I don't know.
Who is that?
Bunch of freaking riffraff.
I'll get it, you know. I'll take care of it.
Yeah, it's nice of you, John.
You know what happened to my housekeeper? There's a garbage can. You want to smoke it?
I'll talk.
Yeah, their whole body. You should start pulling a fucking shirt.
Thank you.
Okay. How's your commute? She heard, I think you're cute. And she goes, I think you're handsome. And then, yeah, she's
so she leave you the key?
Yeah.
The key to the trailer?
I have a key to the city.
Or her trailer, too.
So I totally missed that whole thing. Apparently.
No, you asked! Okay.
Damn it.
He said, he just, you know, how was your commute? And what did she think?
He trolls with it. Trouble hook with it.
Yes. Zoom.
Oh, hello.
Yo, she changed her own life.
Oh, okay. Yes.
I just said, what's your commute?
You know, that's not what she heard.
Marianne,
honestly.
Marianne Toad Rock was looking for you, too.
No, I was the prettiest woman at Toad Rock.
Were you? So you were all in black.
I had the least hair, too, of all the women there that I saw.
They were all sure lined up. All the best of the best were lined up.
There were guys wearing
full-length
black jackets.
Everything.
They were scared.
Like a Colorado serial killer style, right?
Were there any textiles there at all? No Cordura. Maybe a belt or two.
We were about the earthiest.
Outside of the two baristas.
Yeah.
We were the earthiest.
And she says she was a screamer.
That's right, she did. No, she was a howler.
Howler?
No, because we were talking about screaming, and the guy goes, what's your name? And she goes, screamer.
I seen it. Well, did you see? Well, I don't know. You go on there.
Is that what you heard? Yeah. Is that what she said?
That's what she said.
Okay.
But yeah. You said, how is your
she team? Probably, she heard. She probably said, would you like screaming?
No.
You heard what she wanted to hear.
Oh, you're a screamer.
Flat spot here for my helmet pads, and I'm going to design a helmet where no matter what your hairstyle, you take it off.
It looks good. You're quaffed.
And again, you look good. In fact, maybe it'll be a detachable piece.
Actually, you should have like hair gel, like a pump, a hair gel coming out. Like loose.
Yeah.
So you take it off, it's all.
So it's all George Hamilton.
It's all George Hamilton.
I think this came together.
It smells kind of fruity.
The one thing that I notice about this group is that nobody is exactly the same. Nobody has a similar personality trait, a similar humor, bones. Everybody is different and wacky and cool. And, well, you know, come on.
Well,
I think you can only get that with the randomness of the internet.
Well, everyone's going to be some version of weird and wacky.
So today was another very long day of riding. Did about 350 miles today through some of the most amazing scenery that I've seen yet so far. We're here in Goldbridge, British Columbia, and just the road to get here was absolutely amazing. We went through this amazing gorge and river, and some of it was actually very quite hairy getting here, because if you made a wrong turn, you would fall 200-300 feet into a river, and that would, of course, would be bad. Covered in dust and completely tired, and I've finally taken a shower and managed to get a decent meal, and now we're going to be calling it night, getting up early again, and hitting the road early, so I'll be on our way home. Okay.
So today we rode down from Goldbridge down to Whistler, where we decided to take the ferry instead of going through Vancouver and then onto the U.S. border. And then here we are at the waiting for the ferry. We met this really interesting guy. He was in his late 80s, I believe he said, and was a World War II veteran.
Over to England in 1940, May.
Oh, my goodness.
And then we went to Sicily, and we invaded Sicily.
Yeah.
With the British 8th Army, the 1st Canadian Division. So I've been overseeing the boys.
Oh, yeah.
7:30.
Seven.
It's not wrecked. We're gonna get in around 9.
Yeah. I thought we'd get some more rest.
Yeah, well, we're gonna get a lot more rest.
So you're gonna park under the white tent down there.
Okay.
So through the gates down under the white tent, face the street, so you can pull right out and on.
All right.
And customs will be around about 6:15, so you gotta stay in the lot from here on out.
Did you pay?
No.
I only got me this time.
Oh, okay.
I'm not sure if they're gonna check this or not. You think they would?
I don't know. Do you think I should go pay?
I don't know. I can't see what.
Or should I just play like I didn't? I thought you paid.
Yeah, we'll try that.
We'll try that. Let's see what happens. We'll get a discount.
Worst case scenario is I wait for you at Port Angeles and you get to the last. This could be the last fare of the day.
It could be, yeah.
We should have checked a lot better. You can have it all if you like. You can have it all if you like. And you can pay for it the rest of your
Now 12:30, and I'm home. I've been riding since 7:30 this morning, and the battery's about to die finally. This adventure is over.
I'm falling. This place I